As a result of intensive work by research institutes and designing bureaus, the first artificial Earth satellite in the world has now been created. This first satellite was today successfully launched in the USSR.
On Friday, October 4th, 1957, the U.S. received confirmation of the USSR's launch of Sputnik 1, the first artificial Earth-orbiting satellite. It was a polished metal sphere, 23 inches in diameter, with four external radio antennas to broadcast radio pulses. Its radio signal was easily detectable by amateur radio operators. Its 65-degree orbital inclination gave it a flight path that completely covered all parts of the inhabited Earth. While traveling at peak speed, the satellite took 96.20 minutes to complete each orbit. It transmitted on a bandwidth of roughly 20 and 40 megahertz. These signals were monitored throughout the world and continued for 21 days until the transmitter's batteries died on October 26th. The satellite's success was unanticipated by the U.S., setting the space race into orbit as part of the Cold War. That same day, Bing Crosby signed on with the Ford Roadshow for 5 minutes over CBS, announced by Ken Carpenter.
To get a job as a staff announcer for NBC, we've heard many stories about the announcer's test that they had. Did you have to go through all of that?
Not when I got my job at NBC, no. They just opened up down here. And, well, by that time I had some reputation because I did four Rose Bowl games on radio in 1934, 5, and 6. Mm-hmm. Those were released over NBC, of course, so I had a certain amount of reputation. Started doing some network shows when they first started originating network shows, commercial shows, from NBC out here. I won some auditions on those, of course, but not as a staff. No, I didn't have to, because my name was fairly well known by that time.
The Ford Roadshow, starring Bing Crosby.
You're ahead in a Ford all the way.
Brought to you by Ford, the car that saves you most per mile.
Folks, I have a selection here now. It's called Don't Get Around Much Anymore. I'd like to quickly, though, put in a disclaimer that this certainly doesn't apply to my own personal life. I get around a lot because I got a new Ford. I miss the Saturday dance. Heard they crowded the floor. I couldn't bear it without you.
The next Wednesday, October 9th, the Lovell telescope was activated in Cheshire, England, while a Boeing B-47 Stratojet bomber crashed in Orlando, Florida, killing all four military officers on board. On October 10th, a nuclear reactor fire on the northwest coast of England released radioactive material into the air, as President Eisenhower hosted breakfast at the White House with Ghanaian minister to France, Komla Akbeli Bedema, who'd been recently refused out of Howard Johnson's in Delaware because of his race. The next day, an IBM computer at MIT Computation Center in Cambridge, Massachusetts, calculated the last stage of the R-7 Semyorka rocket that carried Sputnik 1. And on Saturday, October 12th, Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh, arrived in Ottawa, the capital of Canada, for a royal visit. The Queen opened the Canadian Parliament on the 14th, the first monarch to do so.
I just can't handle the action like I used to, no. Hey, Mumbles, what's the pitch? You shouldn't mumble like it. It gives you away. They say folks who talk to themselves have got money in the bank.
Oh, no, that can't be true, Bing. But I'm glad you brought up the subject of money. I was adding up miles per gallon I got on my last trip in my Ford, and that means money to me.
What result did you achieve?
Oh, keen, Bing. You won't believe it.
I'm going to believe it, I'll bet I will. Didn't the Ford 6 top all cars in miles per gallon in the mobile gas economy run?
Right. And Fords don't just cost less to run. You know what a guy offered me for mine for the other day?
Well, you're not going to surprise me, Ken. My friends in the industry tell me that, according to this year's car auction figures, Fords have been bringing more in trade than any other low-priced car. That's what they told me.
Maybe this will surprise you, Bing. Ford's big car value costs less to buy than any other car in its class.
The merest child knows that.
This can't be love, because I feel so well. No sobs, no sorrows, no sighs. This can't be love, I get no dizzy spells. My head is not in the skies. My heart does not stand still. Just hear it beat. This is too sweet to be love. This can't be love, because I feel so well. Still I love to look in your eyes. Oh, how I love to look in your eyes.
I guess we're never going to run out of moon songs. It'll always be moon, June, spoon songs. We've got a recent entry now, a new song called Dark Moon.
Your splendor, dark moon. What is the cause your light withdraws? Is it because I've lost my love? Mortals have dreams of love's perfect scheme. But they don't realize that love will sometimes bring a dark moon. All way up high, up in the sky, oh tell me why you've lost your splendor. Dark moon. What is the cause your light withdraws? Is it because I've lost my love? Dark moon.
You know, Bing, I've got a problem.
Well, can't assume a recumbent position on my chaise lounge there and tell me what it is.
How do you convince folks that Ford really does cost less to buy?
Show them the manufacturer's suggested list prices. It shows Ford's the lowest price car of the low price three.
That sounds good. But I want to prove that Ford costs less to run, too.
Well, then you tell them about the mobile gas economy run. Seems to me that Ford 6 really beat the others hands down in miles per gallon.
That's true. Ford did average the most miles per gallon of any car, regardless of weight or size.
That's good.
But here's the clincher. How do I prove that Fords bring more at trade-in time?
Well, that's no serious problem. A look at Ford's years-ahead sculptured style and built-for-keeps inner Ford tells you that the new kind of Ford is going to be worth plenty in trade for a good long while.
Well, if this year's any indication, Bing, you're right. Ford is America's best-selling car.
No problem, Ken. Like I told you, this new kind of Ford sells itself.
I don't want you, but I hate to lose you. You've got me in between the devil and the deep blue sea. I forgive you, 'cause I can't forget you. You've got me in between the devil and the deep blue sea. I'd ought to cross you off my list, but when you come knocking at my door, fate seems to give my heart a twist. I come running back for more. I should hate you, but I guess I love you. You've got me in between the devil and the deep blue sea.
Well, that's all for now. Then thank you very much.
The Ford Roadshow, starring Bing Crosby with Buddy Cole's music, has been brought to you by Ford, the car that saves you most per mile.
You're ahead in a Ford all the way. Listen for the other Ford Road shows with the World News Roundup, Rosemary Clooney, Arthur Godfrey, and Edward R. Murrow.
This is the CBS Radio Network.